In every era, humanity has faced the challenge of safeguarding health and well-being against the backdrop of evolving societies and environments. Today, health policy serves as a cornerstone for implementing effective measures and strategies aimed at improving public health outcomes and mitigating the burden of various diseases and health conditions. But what is health policy, and how does it work?
Hi, I'm Lindsey Haynes-Maslow, and welcome to a journey through the fascinating history of health policy. From early civilizations devising rudimentary sanitation measures to modern governments implementing complex healthcare systems, health policy is a testament to our collective efforts to promote public health and tackle emerging threats. Here, we're going to take a brief look at history and ultimately answer, how does health policy work and why is it important for public health? Our story begins in ancient civilizations, where early regulations aimed to promote public health and safety. In Mesopotamia, for example, Hammurabi's code included laws related to hygiene, food preparation, and water quality, ensuring that communities maintained sanitary living conditions. The Greeks and Romans were pioneers in healthcare, with Hippocrates laying the foundation for medical ethics and practice. Public health policies in ancient Greece focused on sanitation, waste disposal, and quarantine measures during outbreaks of infectious disease. The Romans built elaborate aqueducts and public baths, recognizing the importance of clean water and personal hygiene and preventing illness. During the medieval period, healthcare was often intertwined with religious beliefs and practices. Monasteries served as centers of medical knowledge and charity, providing care for the sick and needy. Medical guilds emerged to regulate the practice of medicine and ensure that practitioners met certain standards and competence and ethics. In the Islamic world, hospitals known as bimaristans were established, integrating medical care and education. The Renaissance brought a resurgence of interest in science and medicine, leading to the establishment of medical colleges and universities. Figures like Andreas Vesalius revolutionized anatomical studies, while Paracelsus challenged traditional medical beliefs with his emphasis on observation and experimentation. Governments began to formalize regulations guiding medical practice, including licensing requirements and standards of care. The Industrial Revolution brought rapid urbanization and new challenges to public health. Overcrowded cities and poor living conditions contributed to the spread of infectious diseases like cholera and tuberculosis. In response, sanitary reform movements advocated for improved clean sanitation, clean water, and housing regulations. John Snow's investigation of the Broad Street Pump cholera outbreak in London highlighted the importance of clean water supply, leading to changes in public health policies and practices. Governments in Europe and North America established health boards to oversee public health policies and enforce regulations aimed at protecting the health of the population. The 19th century saw significant advancements in health policy, with the development of vaccination programs to prevent infectious diseases. Edward Jenner's smallpox vaccine was one of the earliest successful vaccines, paving the way for others. Louis Pasteur's work on germ theory laid the foundation for modern immunization practices, leading to the widespread adoption of vaccines against diseases like smallpox, measles, and polio. Public health campaigns even promoted vaccination and hygiene practices, helping to reduce the burden of preventable illnesses on society. In the 20th century, governments took on a greater role in healthcare delivery and regulation. In 1946, the United States established the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the CDC, which became a cornerstone of national and international health policy and disease prevention efforts. Later, in 1965, the United States introduced health insurance programs, Medicare and Medicaid, providing coverage for vulnerable populations and addressing disparities in healthcare access. These developments significantly expanded access to healthcare services and improved health outcomes for millions of people. Over the second half of the 20th century, the global health landscape underwent significant changes as international collaboration became crucial in tackling emerging health threats and promoting health equity. The creation of the World Health Organization, the WHO, in 1948 marked a pivotal moment in coordinating global health efforts and eventually led to the eradication of smallpox in 1980. Beyond vaccines and disease-specific initiatives, the global health community has also made strides in improving maternal and child health, access to clean water and sanitation, and addressing malnutrition. Now that you know a little about the history, let's talk about how policy works and why it's important. In the United States, there are plenty of pathways to enact policy. At the federal level, we have three branches of government that provide health policy opportunities. These are the legislative, executive, and judicial branches. Public citizens are responsible for electing two branches of a government through voting, the president in the executive branch and senators or representatives in the legislative branch, those in Congress. Oftentimes, we think about Congress voting on bills that are signed into law by the president. However, all branches can impact policy. Having three branches of government is the basic premise for how our country uses checks and balances when passing policies. Congress passes policy, the president enacts it, and even passes their own policies using executive orders. Lastly, the judicial branch, which includes the Supreme Court and other federal courts, is where many public health experts have focused their attention on in recent years. This branch of government can declare laws unconstitutional, and because our country doesn't prescribe to a one-size-fits-all approach to policymaking, it's important to recognize how laws are being passed or overturned. For example, if we want to see action now on a public health topic, we may go through the court system. A decade from now, we may change our strategy to concentrate on the legislative branch, or we could focus on all three branches. When we understand how to push, pull, and direct policy initiatives forward, that is the exact moment we learn to respect the power of health policy. It only takes one policy to advance society, and those that dedicate their careers to this recognize that this work does not get done overnight. In public health, we are here to continue fighting for the safety and well-being for all people in this country. Despite the critical role of health policy in promoting well-being, disparities in access and implementation persist. From systemic obstacles to unequal distribution of power, barriers hinder our progress. As we move forward, the focus is on achieving health equity worldwide, ensuring that every individual has access to quality healthcare. Remember, health policy has evolved throughout history, but our journey toward global well-being continues. Stay informed, stay healthy, and most importantly, remember to vote.